as streams of radiance which illuminate completely and line up order, and is beyond compare. Here, Buddha image was indeed how to be the object to be remembered. As a concrete Buddha's image is used for contemplation, it is easily expected that such a practitioner come to make a Buddha's statue. Also, statues were not made in early Buddhism. This is suspected to be one cause of Buddhist statues starting to be created. However, it is not clear which is earlier, a Buddha statue or meditation on the Buddha's image, like a chicken and egg relationship. Generally speaking, it is usually thought that the period when Buddha's statue started to be created is the 1st century AD, which is earlier than the period the Buddha's image became to be used as an object of Samatha contemplation. The way using Buddha's physical image as an object for the contemplation eventually spread to East Asia. New sutras appear that depicted not only the Buddha's image, but also scenery from the Buddha's dwelling place. The representative sutra of those is contemplations on the sunset of the sun, on the water filled in the middle of Western Pyramid, and on the scenery of the same paradise appear. And those are method to calm mind much by remembering the objects and contemplating on those. In the Visuddhimagga, we can find the practices called Kashina Samadhi, which teaches the meditators to think that this world is filled up by soil, by water, etc. I suspect that based on came from the practices such as Kashina Samadhi. Here, we should be careful not to misunderstand, because all the contemplations from the sunset of the sun, etc. are called Kwan in Chinese, which is also used as a translation of the word Vipassana. The content of these meditations are actually samatha. Generally speaking, in Chinese the word Kwan is used very frequently. However, when we use it as part of idiomatic phrase like samatha and vipassana, as is a common use usage in Theravada Buddhism, then vipassana means the method which guides us to the non-discrimination. But in Chinese, we should always be careful that this part has two possible meanings. This part happens have two possible meanings. When the object of contemplation is limited to one object, it is samatha meditation method. Chanting the Buddha's name, a new method of meditation. After Buddhism was introduced into China, among the many changes that occurred, one remarkable development was a new method of practice of chanting the Buddha's name repeatedly. This is so-called reciting the Buddha's name of Nyingpo. As a founder of the Pure Buddhism in China, is generally regarded as a figure of illusion. However, the monk who made the reciting of the Buddha's name as a basic practice was shut in the Tang dynasty. This is a method of practice by which practitioners concentrate on Buddha both vocally and with their mind. It is thought that there may be continuity from the practice called Shanti Anusati Bhavana, the remembrance of a good word like Nibbana or Buddhi, as found in the Visuddhimagga. The practice of the remembrance of the good words is classified as a type of samatha meditation. Therefore, the practice of chanting the Buddha's name may also be classified as a type of samatha meditation. However, we have to be aware of one issue related to how the Buddha's name was really practiced. In East Asia, it seems that So I chanted the Buddha's name at a very slow speed. I believe that here we can see a distinctive feature of this type of meditation. If we chant at a faster speed, we experience our mind becoming more energetic. Therefore, to avoid this, the name was chanted at a slow speed. In fact, in modern times, the chanting of the Buddha's name as practiced in the Rinzai temple for 7 days in Yangzhou in China, called Boji, is done at a slow speed. And the chanting of the name of Shakyamuni at Tosho Daiji temple, this is in Japan, as well as the Komyo Shingo at Saiyaji, this is also in Japan, in both in Nara, are also practiced at a surprisingly slow speed. How to practice this Shakyamuni, Shakyamuni chanting like this? I'll show it.
I will here quote the sentence of it.
of which the object to observe is the sun as follows. What is the meaning of the meditation in which we observe listening to a sound? It is better for you to think as follows. As far as we admit that the sound observed is empty and unobtainable, the function of listening occurs only after object and organ are combined. Subsequently, the consciousness occurs and forcibly creates the discrimination. With this function, all defilements and dharmas which are good and evil exist. Therefore, we call this listening to sound. Contrary to the ordinary, we observe the function of the mind, and we don't observe the figure of form, sham. Therefore, we can understand that both listener and dharmas are ultimately empty. And this is called practicing observation. Tiantai's explanation says that when the object to be observed and the organ that feels are combined, the function of sense occurs, and subsequently, the function of consciousness occurs, followed by discrimination like disease such occurs. Finally, worries and sufferings occur. So far, is a key to understanding this word. Usually this word means figure or shape, but here it is thought to be a discrimination which occurs after the object to be grasped has been drawn in mind, and the discrimination itself is a figure or a shape. It means that a figure is drawn in mind, that is so-called perception, and it is followed by discrimination, that is so-called consciousness. This consciousness itself is thought to be a shama. Remembering the idea from Theravada Buddhism, it is easy to understand this series of movement in the mind. Our mind accepts the matter of outer world, draws the image to be grasped in our mind, and then discriminate what that image is. And subsequently, as our mind functions will occur one after the other. We are sure that Tieta is looking at the series of mind movements. He says that it is not important to focus on the figure that is discriminated itself, but to focus on the function of the discrimination itself. In conclusion, now I would like to finish my presentation with an overview of meditation from the Theravada Buddhism to the Mahayana Buddhism. My main conclusion is that the difference between the two seems to be much less than we might imagine. For example, there is virtually no difference regarding the function of contemplation, namely that is to come into the working of mind through single-pointedness of mind, or again insight into the full working of the mind. Finally, some differences exist in Mahayana meditation in terms of kamata, including the practice of viewing the Buddha using the image of the Buddha or samatha, in addition to the repetition of the word. Thank you very much.